Hey, what's up? I'm Al Cox. I make games, play games, and everything in between. And today we are talking about HypeHype. HypeHype, you had my curiosity and now you have my attention. This app looks amazing. It's basically TikTok for games. When you load the app, you have multiple simple hyper-casual games that are made by the users. Everything from Crossy Road to Tetris to modern day Pac-Man's, all made by the users. So you can play a game, you can like it, you can even remix and remake the games that you've played all on your phone. HypeHype uses a no-code visual logic scripting. There's a lot going on here.
It also reminds me of Dreams on PlayStation, but for mobile phones.
For those of you that just want to go and download the app now, it's on early access. Go to HypeHype.com, click the join access, fill out the information. When it asks for add a referral or inviter here, be sure to add my name. I am Hypesy on HypeHype. By doing that, it'll let them know this is how you found the app. And let me know what you think of it in the comments below. If you like this kind of content, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more information, as I will be getting into HypeHype and probably spending every day in here trying to make games and playing games. Wait till the end. I'm gonna show you a bunch of the different games that I've been playing on HypeHype. I always find the best research to make games is literally playing games over and over again. That's my learning process. Who is HypeHype? HypeHype is the collaboration between Frogminds, very well known for the game Badlands, which is also one of the first games I ever played on the iPad, and it's a great, beautiful game. You probably played it. And they've teamed up with Supercell, most famously known for Clash of Clans. A lot of people play this game. My brother played that game, probably spent a lot of money too. They have a very unique position in where they have a very creative studio, Frogminds, and Supercell combined. HypeHype, the next level of gaming on mobile phones. They have great documentation, wiki.hypehype.com, and on their Discord channel. So they have templates, lots of amazing assets. First thing I wanna do is go to the Discord channel, because the greatest thing about making a game isn't necessarily the game itself, but the community behind it. And here we can see people just messaging, asking for help, trying to figure out how to do this. The HypeHype staff being super responsive. They have tutorial videos and documentation. I've already gone through and watched a lot of their YouTube videos, and I plan to watch these over and over again because that's how I learn. Everything just looks beautiful. I love the aesthetics. Release notes, this is amazing. They just pushed out a release recently. You can see all the things that they're working on, the things that they've completed. The next channel is live streams. They have weekly live streams with this dude named Shogun who's been using HypeHype for a while and will help answer all your questions. Right now, HypeHype is just super small and people are joining every day. Now just seems like a really good time to get in. News and announcements, general chat, where people just ask random questions and talk about random things and post the hype that they're working on. Each game is called a hype, pretty cool. Give feedback, making the game or you're playing the game and you notice issues because they're still working on it. This is brand new, but oh, looking so good. They'll listen, they'll respond, they'll tell you what's happening. Bug reports, list your bugs here, get editor help, need some specific assistance. This community seems very engaging and I'm all about that. When I started out making games, I took a course in New York City and I paid a lot of money. The best thing I ever learned from that course wasn't so much how to make the kind of games that I want, but instead it was the community of being around other people who wanted to make different kinds of games just like me. And when you're in a community of like-minded folks, it creates opportunity for inspiration of making both simple and complex games that either you've seen or never seen before. Lots of cool stuff. Asset requests. I've spent time playing with the animation of the characters and think there could be more dance moves, so I'm gonna put that in the asset request. It's just a lot of opportunity to grow. Last month they had a game jam where they were giving away over $10,000 worth of prizes. I don't think they're doing this all the time. I think this is just to help introduce HypeHype to the world. Again, on early access, check the links below. And yeah, you can show your hype, works in progress, hype jam suggestions, latest feedback, just a lot going on here. It's very refreshing to see this kind of community already moving and rolling along. It makes me want to dive into the software so much more.
They have a wiki page full of lots of great documentation, both talking about their Discord channel and the visual logic pieces that make up the game creator tool itself. Here we can see those overview of the HypeHype editor, how to create a hype playlist, save and publish hype, release notes and roadmaps, hype jams, live streams, and then we can go into the meat of the game creator tool in terms of visual materials, physical materials. All this documentation has nice images explaining how all the things work. Very detailed. It's really nice to be able to just spend time reading all this stuff. It's kind of a little dorky, but I love to read this kind of information. Even particle effects, how to do particle effects, simple and easy, the different kind of particle effects that are available and how to execute them, lots of documentation. And this is really what you want from a game creator tool. It's just loads and loads of documentation. And here we can see the destroyer. There's 8 different kind of components: action, logic, triggers, meta, audio, joints, vectors, visual, and then the physical, and even generated for tile map. And we can see that all this is followed up with release notes, known issues or bugs, features in development such as multiplayer, upcoming and community requested assets. Participate in this community and the HypeHype staff will engage. This is great. The most amazing thing is this can all be done creating on your phone, your iPad, and even the browser. Like, that's mind-blowing. You can literally make games on a browser. It's unlimited potential. I'm really excited. I do believe this is going to take a little bit to figure out and learn. I have been trying to use my iPhone.
I never even considered making a game on my phone with no code or an iPad because such a thing wasn't even possible, but now it is possible. What wasn't possible yesterday, it's possible today, and I can't wait to show you what I'm gonna do tomorrow. So that's HypeHype. Check it out and be sure to add me as a reference. HypeC, that's my username in HypeHype. Let me know your thoughts below. If you like this content around making and playing games, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button below. And I'm gonna go read some more documentation and play some more games, aka research. So until next time, stay safe out there. Peace.